guys, welcome back to my channel. It's been a long time I've been here, like I've been really busy. Today I'm going to make a classic dish. Like this dish is really dear to my heart, and this dish is Wena Ami and Toshe. This food is known to people from Northern Nigeria. It is really delicious and very easy to prepare. Keep watching this video to see how I make Wena and Ami and Toshe. Don't forget to click the like button and subscribe also. Please guys, subscribe to my channel. Let's get started.
These are the ingredients I'll use for Wena: sugar, salt, ginger, onion, vegetable oil, baking powder, yeast, and non-parboiled white rice. This is how the rice looks like in its grainy form. I'll just take out some, just like so. Just a bit I'll be cooking separately. The next thing I'll do is pour in some water and stir using my hands. I'll pour out the water. You can see the depth is already coming up. I'll wash it again, pour in some water, stir, and remove any form of dirt until it is very clean. This rice is really good, guys. I didn't have to pick out stones, but if you have stones in the one you buy, make sure to pick them out. Pour the water out, and it's now very clean. Yeah. I'll pour in some water and allow it to soak for about 4 to 6 hours. When it soaks, it ferments a bit. As that is soaking, I'll add in the rice I reserved before into a pot of boiling water. I washed this rice off camera, guys, so it's clean, don't worry. So I'll stir and allow it to cook nicely, and it's cooked and very soft now. I've taken out the quantity I need, about 2 to 3 tablespoons, because the quantity I cooked came out plenty. You know, it smells like crazy, guys. So I'll just put my fully soaked rice into my blender. I'll add some water, my garlic and onion, and I'll blend everything together. Onion goes in, and then blend. Until smooth. I'm now adding in the cooked rice. You can blend it if you like, you can leave it like that, you can add it before or after, it works well as well. I'm transferring it into a large bowl. See how fluffy that looks. And I'm going to add some of my ingredients. Add in some sugar, salt, and baking powder. The quantity of sugar depends on you, really. I added little sugar because I'm pairing mine with Ami and Toshe. But you can add as much as you like when you're eating it with the Yaji or Kulikuli. The choice is absolutely yours. But remember, guys, too much of sugar is not good, so be careful when you're adding it. And I'll give this a quick mix. I'm adding in my yeast now, and I'll mix it very well. I told you guys, this dish is one of my favorite northern dishes. It's a classic dish from Arewa, where I'm from, and I love it. It's really dear to my heart. I'll allow this to rise for about 3 to 4 hours before we fry. Yeah. Has now risen and it's ready for frying. There's a pan they use for frying Wena. They call it Costco in house. I don't know what they call it in English, really. You can see how it looks, it has holes in it. So I'm adding in some vegetable oil in each hole, and I'll allow the vegetable oil to heat up. When it's hot, I'm going to add in the mixture just like this into each hole, not filling it to the top so much. and I'm going to allow this cook for about 3 to 4 minutes. And when it starts to form bubbles like pancakes, I'll flip it over. It's now ready for flipping. Flip over and allow it to cook some more. I love it when it's a little burnt like this. Yes, that's how I like it. I'm going to repeat this process until the mixture is finished. Flip this one. Oh, that one is not ready yet. These are the ingredients for mie entoshi: salt, seasoning cube, palm oil, ground crayfish, locust beans, garlic, ginger, dried pumpkin. This is optional and I'm using the dried ones because I couldn't find the fresh ones. Ground peanuts, fresh tomatoes, scotch bonnet, red bell peppers, onions, spring onions, some meat of choice. I'm using chicken, beef and pomo today. And of course spinach. Look how the spinach looks green and fresh and beautiful. I'll add in the meat into a pot and I'll spice it up. I'll spice it up with some garlic and ginger. I'll just grate in my garlic and ginger quickly. Salt, onion and seasoning cubes. Then I'll stir everything together. I'm going to place the meat on fire, then I'll add in some water and allow it to cook. Stir it and allow it to cook nicely. Oh, before I forget, let me add in the pumpkin so they all cook together. The pumpkin is sweet and it sweetens the meat, so the sweetness of the pumpkin infuses into the meat and it's just so wonderful. I'm using soft chicken, so I'll take out the chicken first and allow the rest of the meat cook some more. And this is how the meat and the pomo looks. As that is cooking, I'll throw in my tomatoes, peppers and onion and I'll blend it together. I'll chop my spinach nicely, set it aside, cut my spring onions and onion. Everything looks so green. I love vegetables. Now set everything aside. In the same pot I cooked the meat, I'll add in some palm oil and allow it to heat up. I took out the meat off camera and I set it aside. I'll throw in my onion and allow it to fry for about 2 minutes. Keep that to stir. I'm now adding my blended tomato and pepper and I'll allow it to fry for about 5 minutes. It doesn't really need much frying like stew. The meat and the stock goes in now. I'll give that a quick stir. And I'll now spice it up with some local ingredients. Adding my locust beans, crayfish. It's already scenting nice already. Give that a stir. And our Nike can get that goes in now. That is peanuts, guys. That is brown peanuts in Hausa. And I'll allow this cook nicely for about 15 minutes on low heat so it doesn't get burnt on there. And I'll allow it to cook and thicken the soup. And our delicious mee and toshi is ready to be devoured to our weina or tuen shinkafa. I have a recipe for tuen shinkafa on my previous video. Hope you guys enjoyed this recipe. Please, please guys, subscribe for more delicious recipes.